Up to now, we have learned how to insert dimensions and letters, and most importantly, how to modify them. However, it is highly recommended that you do not modify the existing styles. In every drawing, we can create as many new annotation and letter styles as we wish, and we can even insert those styles from Design Center in different drawings. As you can see, I have opened one of my existing drawings. I will expand the annotation panel of the Home ribbon and open the Dimension Style Manager. Let's say I wish to create a dimension style based on the standard style. I will select the standard style and click on the New button. The Create New Dimension Style window appears. In the New Style Name field, I will type the phrase Architectural Style and then I will click on Continue. Now that the name was set, the New Dimension Style window opens and I can modify the dimension style as I wish. I will start by changing the precision from the Primary Units tab to 2 decimal places. Then, I will move to the Text tab and change the text alignment to align with the dimension line. Next, I will activate the Symbols and Arrows tab and change the arrowhead type to Architectural Tick. Finally, I will return to the first tab, which is the Lines tab, and I will set the fixed length for the extension lines and the extent beyond ticks value to 0.3. Now I will click OK to save the changes in this style and notice that the new style I created has been added in the list. I can make this dimension style the current style if I click on the Set Current button. I will also close the Dimension Style Manager window to create a new letter style tool. I will expand the annotation panel of the Home ribbon once again, and this time I will click on the Multi-letter Style icon. Once the Multi-letter Style Manager window opens, I will select the standard style and click on the New button. I will change the name of the new letter style to Detail Callout, and then I will click Continue. The Modify Multi-letter Style window opens, so I can make some changes to this letter style. In this example, I will go straight to the Content tab and change the letter type to Block. From the available blocks, I will select the Detail Callout, and I will also change the scale to 50. Now I am ready to click OK and set this letter style as the current style before closing the Multi-letter Style Manager window. At this point, I will place a linear dimension and a callout detail letter to see the result. When I insert the callout detail letter, I have to specify the attributes of this letter, which is the view number and the seat number. In this example, I will not insert values in those fields and I will just click OK. As long as I have saved the file and closed the application, I can insert the dimension and letter styles of this drawing into a new one or an existing one from the Design Center.